Hi, my name is Maciek and I'm an engineer on Google Web Designer. Today I'll show you how to use Google Web Designer's event system. By the end of this video, you'll know how to set up event handlers in your documents. I've prepared a simple document for us to use, which contains a carousel gallery and a blue div. In order to add event handlers to your document, you're going to want to find the events panel here on the right side. This will show you a list of all of your installed event handlers. We don't have any handlers yet here, so the list is empty. But if you have a lot of them, you can sort and filter through them. To add event handlers to this list, we're going to need to bring up the events dialog. There are a couple ways to get to that dialog. One way, if you already know which target you want to select, you can right-click on an element and select Add Event. This will set the selected element as your target. Instead, let's deselect that element and open the events dialog using this little plus icon in the corner. This will open up the events dialog without any preferences selected. The first thing we want to do is select a target. This is the element that'll trigger our event handler. For this example, I'm going to choose the carousel. Next, we need to choose an event which will trigger our event handler. Most elements support mouse and touch events. Since this is a carousel, it also supports some special specific events. I'm going to select the click event, and now we get to choose an action. This is the action that we want to perform in response to the event. Most elements support setting CSS styles and adding custom actions, which we'll get to in a minute. If you have other custom elements in your documents, they might have additional events here for you to select. For this demo, I'm going to choose Set Styles. Next, we're going to choose a receiver. This is the element whose CSS we want to change. For this demo, I'm going to choose the blue div. And I'll assign some CSS properties to it. I'll change the background color of the div to be red. You can choose some easing options, add a duration, and click OK to save. That's it. We've added an event handler to our document. Now we can go ahead and preview the document and see what we've made. Now we see when I click on the carousel, the blue div slowly changes to red. That was pretty easy. Now let's say we've made a mistake and we want to change our event handler. We don't need to make a whole brand new event handler, we can just edit the one that we've currently made. If you double click on the event handler, it'll open up the events dialog in editing mode. Let's go back to the actions screen and select custom action. Here you can write any valid JavaScript code. I'm going to go ahead and give the code a function name. And for the purpose of this demo, let's just make an alert call. That looks good. Now click OK to save. We see that our event handler has been updated to show that we're going to call my function. Let's preview it. Now when I click on the carousel, we see the alert statement come up. I love Google Web Designer. That's it for today. If you have any questions about events or any other Google Web Designer topics, just post them in the comment section. Thank you.